It's okay, love. You're safe now.
We just want to help you.
You and the others. Now, what can you tell us about where you were kept?
I showed you. I showed them.
Oh, you said you were moved. What about before that? Where were you?
I don't know. I don't know. Another room. They're going to kill them. They are going to kill them. I know they are.
Remember, we gave them the microfilm.
You don't understand. They don't trust anyone.
Celia,
they are going to kill them.
Celia, please, please, you've got to try to help us.
I should have been smarter. I should have realized about Grant a long time ago.
Come on, look, it's all behind you now. We got to find Luke and Holly now.
No, 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 it's too late. It's too late.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. It is. It's
not
too late.
It's not too late. Hey, look, calm down, will you?
You don't
calm
know
down.
People, Robert.
Everything's going to be fine.
Our generation, we knew because we listened to our elders.
These kids today, thinking they can make these decisions themselves.
They don't think. They don't even know.
And just rush right in. That's their answer to everything. It was very smart what you told them.
Please call me Isaac.
Isaac.
And as for my being smart, well, if I knew all that you told them, I might have kept my mouth shut.
No, 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 Isaac. What you said is what made the difference. And, you can call me Maureen if you're so inclined.
Well, I am so inclined. To my new friend, Maureen Clancy, a credit to her generation.
Oh, and to Rose and your dear nephew, Jake, who one way or another, we're going to make understand our viewpoint.
Which is?
What must be, must be.
It's been my experience that if you stare at it, it never rings.
I can't help it.
Get up, go out, take a walk or something.
Well, it's been my experience. If the very second you do that, then it will ring.
Every time.
I know. I tell you, I'm going nuts. I'm absolutely going nuts. If I knew something, Rose, if I just knew something, I don't care if it's the worst possible thing. It's better than not knowing anything.
Are you sure about that? The worst possible news?
Well, no, I guess not.
You know not.
I don't know. You know, Ruby said soon, right? She said soon, sometime today, and I got a feeling from her voice. It could be just any second.
She'll call, and if not her, somebody will.
Well, what if she does? I mean, what if she gets so carried away that she forgets to call?
Yeah, it's a possibility.
I've got to do something.
But what?
I'm asking you.
Oh, I get it. Looking for solutions, huh?
Yes, I'm looking for anything.
Try calling Robert again.
Oh, I just get Ballentine.
Maybe. Then again, you might get Robert. It's worth a try anyway.
Okay, I guess maybe you're right, but oh, I hope I don't get Ballentine. That man can be so rude. Robert!
Sorry, Tiff. Look, there's no time to talk, love.
No, 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 wait. Please, this is important.
Look, be quick, will you? We got Celia here.
Did you find Holly and Luke?
Well, look, I've got to go, love.
Would you wait just a second, please? Claudia, she saw Gregory.
Where? When?
Yesterday at that, you know, that African thing.
Yeah, I know. I met Gregory there. Face-to-face encounter.
Well, isn't he one of the people you're looking for?
Look, I've got to go, all right?
No, wait,
I'll call you later.
Why didn't somebody tell us? What are you
all right?
So far?
You're all right.
Monica, let's get her to the hospital.
Yes. Come on, what are we waiting for?
We can't drive her there.
We have to question her.
Not here, you're not.
No, you're not.
Maybe at the hospital. Come on, you're all right now. Come on.
Well, I think we ought to get over there.
No. I'll go alone. You stay here in case someone in the field calls up. That could be something right now.
Let's find out.
Scorpio.
Robert, it's Bert. I thought I'd better check in. Did you get anywhere with Celia?
Not yet, but we're working on it. What do you guys got?
Well, they're all over the city, but no sign of Luke or Holly anywhere. At expo, the airport, bus station, train depot, you name it.
Damn!
Robert, you still there?
Bert, keep working on it. And if you come up with anything at all, will you call us here?
Yeah, we'll do.
Thank you. It's okay. We're gonna find her.
Well, there's a clue out there somewhere, and I'm gonna find it.
Turned out the way they did, it wouldn't have been too late.
No, I guess it wouldn't. But it was my fault, you know. I held on to that damn desk. I think it was the lamest thing I've ever done.
Then why did you do it?
I don't know. kind of got a kick out of it, I guess. I saw Grant drop it. I knew everybody wanted it. I soon found out it was the awesome Prometheus disc. I had it. And nobody knew I had it.
So you didn't know how important it was?
Oh, sure. I saw Robert and the whole WSB busting their buns to try and get a hold of it. And I knew where it was, and... Oh, the truth is, I had something Robert wanted. And he's had someone I wanted. That made us even.
You know, that's incredibly irresponsible.
I know it's irresponsible. You don't have to tell me that. But don't forget, I was crazy and I was angry. Robert raided my place, he sided with Lee, and a bunch of stuff that really doesn't matter anymore. The point is that when I found out what I had and what was at stake, I was going to give it back. And then I found out that the DVX had a mole at the WSB offices in Washington. And at that time, Holly, I felt that I was the only person responsible. I felt that I had to take care of it. I had to hold on to it.
But you still held on to it even after Gerald was killed and then Natalie?
Yeah, I know, okay? I know that. I made some real stupid mistakes. But I thought I was doing the right thing. And I was very confused, and everybody around me was lying to me. So I went up to the mountain, and I talked to my friend Jed, and he kind of put my head back on for me.
That was when you decided to turn it over to Robert?
That's right. I went to your house, and I was going to give it to Robert. Grant was there. And then I realized that the WSB was willing to sacrifice you and Celia for that disc. Now this I cannot understand, nor will anybody ever be able to make me understand. So I figured the best thing to do was kind of hang with Grant for a while. So I did, until he knocked me out, stole the disc, and the rest is history.
A lot has happened, you know. And we have both changed a lot.
Yes. We've changed a lot. I've made some gross errors the last few months. But I will never forget that about a year ago, I met a lady on the top of a mountain. And I fell in love with her. And we had some real magic times together. And I don't regret a moment of it.
Once, and he said there'd be no friction in this world if people would just leave each other alone. You know, you do what you want to do, and I do what I want. And if we're lucky, never the twain shall meet.
My old grandfather said the same thing. In Yiddish, of course, but it meant exactly the same.
Oh, I never knew.
What's that?
Well, that people of such different cultures and heritages could be agreeing on the same thing so easily.
That's because we care about our heritage.
Purity. Yes, sir. That's the issue.
You know, Jake is a good boy. We should realize that. But somewhere along the line, he just got misdirected.
Misdirected? Oh, that's a good word, Isaac.
I think it was that law school he went to. Before that, he was always, you know, close to home. Never wandered around, that boy.
Well, how do I explain Rose? She had a very strict upbringing. She's got no excuse, and I'm not going to be making any excuses for her.
Rose is a lovely young woman. I won't deny that.
I've got nothing against Jake, and that's the truth. They're both very nice people. All we're asking is that they keep on being nice.
But separately.
Exactly what I mean. Oh, you know, Isaac, we're like two minds with the same thought.
Yes, like two trains running along parallel tracks, same destination.
Ah, you do have a way with words.
You'll find that words are my life.
Mine too.
Really? You read a lot?
No, but I talk a lot. Oh, dear, now. You know, I never had much education. But I do wonder sometimes what they're learning these days.
How to meet a shiksa.
A what?
Shiksa. That's Yiddish for a woman, well, like Rose, you know, who is not of Jewish heritage.
It's not derogatory, I hope.
Oh, no. Oh, no, no more than calling a Jew,
a Hebrew.
Yes, something like that.
Oh. You be the Hebrew, and I'll be the shiksa. No, then everyone will be happy. Yeah, would you like another cup of tea?
No. As a matter of fact, I'm going over to the expo. I want to see that Israeli pavilion.
Oh, fancy that. Now, myself, I was going over to see the Irish pavilion.
Well, would there be any harm in my accompanying you?
Well, we could share the cab fare.
Oh, no. I insist. This is my treat. Come. Oh. And while we're there, you can show me your pavilion, and I'll show you mine.
Oh, you got a deal now.
Right. The money's on the table, Rose.
Explain that to me.
What?
Basing a friendship on keeping two people apart who love each other.
Now, who's doing that?
Jake's uncle and my friend from the Daughters of Ireland, Mrs. Clancy.
But why?
They're not big on mixed romances, I guess.
What, you and Jake? Oh, come on, what's so mixed about that?
It's mixed up is what it is. Excuse me, I'm going to go in the kitchen and break something.
Buy something to me, would you please?
Surely.
So, haven't heard anything yet, have you?
They found her.
Celia?
The last I heard, she was at Robert's.
Leora. Jesse, I need an examining room right away.
Orderly, wheelchair,
right.
Stat.
Jesse, we're going to need a room, also a private room. She's going to be spending the night.
Mm-hmm. All right, what's wrong?
Well, for the moment, let's just say nervous exhaustion.
I have some water. I want some water.
In a moment, Celia.
Water.
Come on, let's go over to the lounge. Would you just sit down?
Okay.
I'll prepare examining room 202, please, emergency, and we'll need a private room on 7. Thank you.
Thank you, Jesse. Thank you very much. Look, Robert, no. Excuse me.
Wait a minute. You've got to let me question her.
No way.
Listen, she is probably the only person that can help me.
Commissioner, she is in no condition to talk to anybody.
Lives are depending on what that woman can tell me.
Yes, and my patient's health is most important, Robert.
All right. A moment.
Robert?
Alan, you can't talk to her now, Robert. Later on.
Come on,
let's get her.
You have
to be sedated.
All right, let's get her out of here.
Let's go.
Look, Quentin, Edward... And you too, Robert. You might as well just stay here because you're not going with us.
I'll tell you, I've got a better idea. Why don't you all go home? We'll call you.
Well, absolutely not. I'm going to stay here.
Yes, me too.
Don't worry about me. I'm going nowhere.
All right, fine then. We'll call you if we know anything.
Yes.
Okay.
Sir.
Can I interest anybody in a cup of coffee?
No, thank you. No, I'm going to stay here and wait.
Robert?
No, thank you, but I've got some other things to do.
Jesse, tell Ruby and Bobby that I want to see them.
All right. Shall I tell them what it's about, if they
ask? Just tell them I'm here, and then I want to talk to them, please.
That isn't good news.
I only wish. Come over here. Talk.
Someone said they've got Celia.
Yeah, she's tired, upset, and unhappy.
What about me?
And Holly?
Sit down, I'll tell you. Okay. They haven't been released yet.
Why? I thought you'd made a deal.
Yeah, well, they obviously want to check out the validity of the ransom.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, it's a bit of microfilm with some rather valuable information on it. As soon as they find out that the check's out, I'm sure that they'll release Luke and Holly.
What does Celia have to say?
From what she can remember, well, not a hell of a lot. It's not been of much help to us.
But they are safe.
Yeah, from what I can understand, they're alive and in good shape.
How long?
I guess that depends on how long it takes them to check out the microfilm.
Lord, cafeteria's jammed. You can't even get a seat.
Oh, good, then you can pace with me.
I'm sure she'll be all right.
No, I'm going to stay and not believe until I hear from a doctor. Edward.
Dr. Perez reports...
How is she? They told me you brought her here.
Just relax. Nobody can see her.
She all right?
Well, as far as we know, you might as well grab a seat.
What you got there?
Coffee. You can get it in the cafeteria.
Okay, I'm going to go get some. Tell me if anything happens, all right?
Mm.
All right.
Main desk, Mrs. Brewer. Yes, hold on a moment, please. Robert, phone call for you.
Excuse me. Scorpio.
Good afternoon, Commissioner. Don't bother to try and trace this call. It's going to be a very short one.
How did you know I was here?
Ballentine. I told him I'd only speak with you.
The deal was for 3 hostages.
And you shall have them. As soon as we're certain that the microfilm contains the genuine equation.
It obviously doesn't matter that I gave you my word.
Oh, I trust you,
Commissioner. But you have such disreputable friends.
Gregory? Hello?
You got a feel for Robert and what he's going through right now.
There's a lot more at stake here than just his wife.
Not to him, there isn't. Look, I'm going to put some coffee on. Call me if anything comes through, all right?
Right. It's Ballentine. That's right. Mr. Secretary? Yes, sir. Yes, good news first. The first hostage has been released. Yes, sir. The other two are definitely alive. No, sir. No, sir. There's not even the remote chance that the phony part of the equation can be detected. I don't think the DVX are all that smart. At least I hope not. What if they are? Well, then I'll be responsible for the death of Robert Scorpio's wife.
You know, in a way, I feel relieved because for a long time I knew it wasn't going to work out for us.
You know, I think we worked it out today.
I hope so. And I want you to understand this because I mean it. I want you and Robert to be happy together.
Thank you. We will be, I'm sure, assuming that you and I live long enough to see him again.
If it's Grant, we have to try to communicate with him. Ah, dinner, another Gulistani desert feast. What is this? Goat's head soup, camel dung pie, mystery meat. You ordered this from Kelly's Diner?
Very funny, Mr. Spencer, but you always did have a unique sense of humor.
Thank you.
I think you should laugh now. If the microfilm turns out to be a phony, it'll be your last one. Did you see that?
Yes, he signaled us. What does it mean?
It means he's on our side. It means we're not alone. Give me your hands. It means Grant is going to help us. That's what it means.
Okay.